I was just reading the Back to Godhead, which Mukunda Anbi Prabhu had put in the temple, the recent edition of Back to Godhead. So there is an article there which was written by a lady who was born in China.
Mm.
Now she's living in America, but she was born in China.
Mm.
So she wrote an article about how astronomers are calculating how far away is the sun and when did the creation take place.
She feel amazed about the creation.
Yeah, about the distance between the sun and the diameter of the universe, and how long the universe has been in creation. And she was comparing the information which the modern day astronomers have to the information which in Srimad Bhagavatam. But they're not the same. There's a definite difference between the two opinions.
这两者之间的意见呢，并不完全相同。
But she explained that that's expected because the information which the astronomers have, that is information which is coming from the past.
她觉得这一点也不意外，是意料中的事，因为呢，在这个经典上所说的跟这些所谓
When you look up at the sky and you look up at the planets in the sky, you're going into the past. Because light takes time to travel. So even though it's coming from very, very far away, the other stars and planets are very far, very far away. So it all takes time to come before we can actually see the light, we see the stars.
So, 这个需要很长，因为距离非常远，也需要时间，所以我们看到的时候，已经是它之前很久以前发出来的光了。So
she said, there's a saying that when you look up onto the sky, you're looking into the past.
所以她这个女士就说了，当你去看着天空的某一个星球的时候，你等于是看着过去。But
she said, actually, we could rephrase it that when we look up to the sky, we're looking at the form of the personality of God.
而他又描述，当我们去看着天空的时候，实际上我们可以看到，是至尊人格守神的这个形态。
Because there's a universal form, and all the different planets and stars, they all represent part of that universal form.
因为呢，主，他也有他的宇宙形体，所以这些各个星球呢，也代表主的这个宇宙形体的部分。So
one time Srila Prabhupada came to a gallery, an art gallery, and he was also invited to speak.
有一回呢，他去到一个画廊，也是被邀请来做一些讲述。And
in the art gallery, they had paintings similar to what we see here today.
那在那边的画廊，也跟我们看到今天类似的一些图画，这些图。Modern
art.
就所谓的现代艺术。
So we Prabhupada said, this is illustrations of the Brahman, these are all impersonal paintings.
那包括他说这一些图画这样子的呢，都是对于梵啊 Brahman 这个梵的这个描述这样子。
Yeah, there is the personal aspect of the Supreme. There's also the impersonal aspect.
所以至尊主有一部分是非人格的部分，另外一个是人格的部分。
So here you can see these illustrations, the paintings here today. They're representing the impersonal aspect of the Supreme.
所以我们在这里看到的这些图片，这些图画呢，是在说明的这个主的非人格的部分。
But devotees see everything in relation to the Supreme. The impersonal aspect is also part of, is also a feature of the Supreme Personality of God.
而奉献者们呢，看到所有的一切跟至尊主都是有关联的，像这一类的也是主的一个展示。
The impersonal Brahman is described in the Bhagavad Gita.
在非人格的梵呢，比这个儒家梵歌更伟大。
No.
Greater.
It's described. It's described in the Bhagavad Gita.
The Brahman is.
It is described. I didn't see how it's described. It is described.
Yeah. 的描述。国家梵歌里面有描述到这个主的这个梵的部分。
What is the how to describe the Brahman? It is just in, there's no personality there, but there's the energy, there's the light of the Lord.
那怎么样来描述这个梵呢？这个梵呢，它是没有人格性的，不是一个人格，然后它只是一种能量，还有一些光。
People are often attracted, they want to enter into that oneness of the Brahman.
人们呢经常受到这个吸引呢，那么想要进入到梵的境界。
They want to get away from being a person. They're so good, they have so many problems being a person.
那么他们就说想要避免，就说在人之间会有很多的问题，所以他们想要逃离这个人的状态。
We know living in the material world, there are always problems. There's so many conflicts in the world.
我们都知道，在物质世界生存总是有很多的问题，经常都是有各种冲突的。
You can see Russia fighting with the brother. Their brothers, their Soviet brothers in the Ukraine. They're fighting.
我们可以看到像这个苏俄这个俄罗斯跟他们的兄弟就是乌克兰啊，他们是原来是兄弟，那就这样子在对他挑战作战。
And there's always this ongoing conflicts between people of different identities, different races. We're quarreling, fighting with each other for stolen bread. Yes, stolen bread. We're fighting over the bread. This is my bread. Someone is saying, no, it's my bread.
My bread. 我们在偷这个，对吧？我们在吵着，就是说谁有的这块这个偷来的面包，说你的面包，我说我的面包。
And who does the bread actually belong to? It actually belongs to the Supreme Lord. Everything comes from Him.
那这个面包到底属于谁呢？那其实所有的一切呢，都是从至尊主那边而来的。
We are claiming it's my bread, it belongs to me.
我们在那宣称说，这是我的面包，属于我的。
What is mine? Nothing is actually mine.
什么是我的呢？其实没有什么是我们的。
When we were born, we take birth in this world, we have nothing.
当我们出生的时候，我们进到这个世界的就是赤裸裸的。
A And when we leave the world, we take nothing.
而且我们离开这个世界，离开这个躯体的时候，也带不走任何东西。
But in the course of our span of years in this world, we're claiming, this is my kingdom, my land, my property.
然而我们在这个世界存活的时间呢，我们一直在累积，甚至去宣称，这个是我的东西，我的财产，我的什么什么。
My country, this belongs to me.
或者说我的国家啦，这个属于我的。
So in Srimad Bhagavatam, there's a chapter called the Bhumi Gita.
所以在我们室内国家瓦坛有一个章节称为这个 Bhumi 哈，这个 Bhumi 就是大地女神啊，大地女神之歌。
The Gita song. There's many Gitas, Bhagavad Gita. There's also Gopi Gita, there's Venu Gita, there's also this Bhumi Gita.
这个 Gita 是歌曲的意思，所以有很多的很多的歌曲啊，有 Gopi Gita 这个牧牛姑娘们的歌曲啦，还有这个 Bhumi Gita 大地女神的歌曲啦，谁谁谁的歌曲。
Venu Gita.
还有 Venu Gita 就是。
Bhagavad Gita.
国家梵歌。
So, Bhumi, Mother Earth, she is laughing at these kings. The different kings were fighting, and each king is claiming, "This land belongs to me."
所以这个大地母亲呢，就在那边笑着，就是说啊，这些国，她笑着这些国王们。这些国王们自己在那边宣称的说，这个是属于我的，什么属于我的。
But Mother Bhumi is laughing because the land was here before the kings, and the land will be here after the kings.
所以大地母亲呢就在笑着，就是说啊，在这些国王们出现之前，这个大地都已经存在了。啊，这些国王离开之后，这些大地也是存在的。
So.We want to come to a higher consciousness to understand actually nothing is mine.
所以我们要提升到这个更高的知觉来了解其实没有什么是属于我们的。
So long as we are trying to progress materially, then we cannot understand the supreme absolute truth.
只要我们想要在物质方面的持续发展的话，那就是说可以知道呢，没有什么真正是属于我们的。
Queen Kunti is talking like that in her prayer.
这个昆蒂皇后在她的祈祷文中说的。
Janma Aishwarya Shuta Shibir Edamana Madapuma Naivahati Avidatum Vai.Queen Kunti talks about the four goals of material life.
Kunti 王后说着，所谓物质生活的四个目标。
First of all, Janma, the birth. We should have a good birth. We're born in a noble family, in a high position in society.
第一项就是说这个出生 Janma, 就是说我们应该出生一个好的背景啊，好的社会，好的家庭，这些条件。
And then Aishwarya, opulence, people very strong desire for opulence.
那再来叫 Aishwarya, 就是说富裕，人们强烈的渴求富裕。
And then Shruta means learning. People spend a lot of money, a lot of time and energy for education.
再来是 Shruta, 就是说学习研究，人们花了很多的金钱，很多的时间，很多的精力去做学习跟研究。
The efforts people will take to do well in exams.
就是说人们呢要很好的去学习，然后去念的书念得很好，通过考试。那有人就是说利用这个来赚钱的。
The students in 高中 when they have to take the exam.Before they go to get a good place in a university, tremendous pressure, a lot of stress, a lot of anxiety.
中学啊高中生们呢就要接受承受很大的压力，要准备升再进一步的升学考试这些。
The parents will take their child to the, or the son or the daughter, take them to the school for the exam. After the exam, they come out and the mother will fan.
这个父母亲呢就带着小孩的去准备考试上考场，然后学生呢全神贯注，然后进去考场，然后考完出来，这母亲呢帮他按摩，然后帮他扇扇子，这小孩就跟我讲讲。
Did it happen to you?
这个怎么发生在你们身上？去联考的时候。
And the other thing, she means beauty.It's also a very important thing in the world today.
还有另外一项是 shi, 就是说美丽啊，这在物质世界也是一个很重要的一个情况。
People spend a lot of money, time, energy to look nice, to look beautiful.
人们呢花了很多的金钱，还有时间呢，就让自己身体去变得看起来更美。
When you look at the shops on the street, you see a lot of shops, many shops, that they're concerned with the skin, how to make the skin and the hair nice. And just the nails also, of course.
然后我们走到街上了，看到很多的商店啊，很多商店是卖那种什么护肤啦、美容产品这一类的。
So when we are meditating, when we are thinking in consciousness of these things, then it will certainly be a big obstacle to our spiritual progress.
所以当我们想着这些物质目标的时候，这肯定是我们在灵性前进派呢，就通过声音的震荡，所有一切的改变呢，都是从声音的震荡来做进行。
This is confirmed also in the Christian Bible.
这一点呢，在基督教的圣经里面也确认了。
In the Bible, it said, "In the beginning was the Word."
圣经里面说的，在创造之初呢，是有一个世界。
So when Srila Prabhupada heard this statement from the Bible, he said, "Yes." He said, "That's what the Vedas say."
所以，包括看到这个叙述说，是的，这个在韦达经典也是这么说，是这么样说的。
Everything comes from sound.
所以一切呢都是从声音的出现的。
There are five elements in the material world, five gross elements.
在物质世界有五个粗糙的元素。
Air, water, fire, air, ether.
就是水、火、土、空气。
So ether.
还有一个以太。
That's the finest element.
这个以太也可以说是我们一般口头上称呼是最精细的。
That's the first element in the material creation.
那在物质世界的创造的第一个元素就是这个以太真空。
Is there any form there in the sound?
在声音里面有没有看到什么形体呀？
No.
没有。
Is there any smell there?
有，
声音里面有没有味道？
没有。
Is there any taste there?
那声音有没有什么味？滋味？
没有。
Can you touch that sound?
你可以去碰那个声音吗？
不可以。
No.
There's only the one quality in ether that is sound.
所以在这个以太只有一个品质，就是声音。
So sound is the first element in the creation.
所以声音是在创造里面的第一个元素。
And then from the sound, the next element which comes about is the air.
那么从声音开始之后，再来出现的元素是气，或是说空气。
So with air, it's a little different from sound.
那么在空气跟声音之间有一些差别。
What do you think the difference is?
你们认为空气跟声音有什么不同？
In air, is there sound?
在这个空气中有声音。
And there's sound in the air?
没有。
Yes, there is. We're speaking. You can hear, right?
所以我们就想说，我们在讲话，你们听到声音。
What other quality is there in air?
在这个空气，这个气里面还有什么品质？
气味。
There's touch.
触觉.
Just like if the air con is on, if you feel the air, you feel the wind, you can feel the wind. Or the fan is on, the electric fan, you feel the air.
就说空气的流动，不管说冷气，我们会感到它的这个冲击的力量，或者说电扇在吹，也有它的这个力量啊，触觉让我们感到触动。
So the finest element was ether. In ether there is sound.
所以最精细的粗糙元素是这个以太，那在以太的品质是这个声音。
And from ether comes air.
然后从以太再发展出这个空气。
And with air, there is sound, and there's also touch.
所以在气就有。 这个声音这个品质，还有一个是触觉这种品质。And
then the next element which comes after the air, then you get fire.
然后从气接着再展示出火这个品质。So
what qualities are there in fire?
在火里面有什么品质？热。味觉。味觉。Taste.
You can see the light.
Huh?
See the light.
You can see. It has form, right? It has a form. Sometimes a little light, sometimes a big light, burning.
Forms
will be
there.
There will be sound. There will be touch, and there will be also form.
所以在火里面就会包含前面的声音，然后还有一个是触觉，再来一个是形体，三个。And
from fire you get water.
然后从火再转变生成水。And
what quality is there in water?
那水的品质是什么？
吴老师，凝视。为什么？它的特流动。Water
has
flowing.
Water's flowing, yeah, but something may not all water is flowing.
所以当然水一般是有一个流动。My
water is not flowing.
但并不是所有的水都是流动的。
This water is not flowing.
比方说定在这里的水，杯子里面的水就没有动。
Water has. What does Krishna say in the Bhagavad Gita?
Test.
Yes.
Test.
Yes.
Test.
然后就像在《国家梵歌》里面说了什么呢？就是说水有一个味道，滋味。
With water, there is also form.
而且水也是有形体的。
There is also touch.
然后也可以有触觉的。
And there's also sound.
而且有声音。
You can go.
然后空气不是也有形体， also air.
You say the air also has form.
Sometimes if the air is colorful, you can see.
I don't see any form in the air.
Like the air is colorful.
That's because of other article. I mean,
like cloud.
But that's a cloud. That's not air.
Oh, that's water.
Clouds are water. There's water in the cloud, not just air.
如果说气的话呢，啊。So it's never colorful.
云呢是包括了水跟空气。
Contains something.
所以它没有那个。
If there's colorful air, it contains something.
The color. There's
no form. You look, there's air in this room. Can you see any form of
所以空气没有熏蒂，不然我都被压死
了。没错没错。
如果空气有熏蒂，我们都被压死了。
Try to understand how everything is so systematic in the creation.
所以试着来了解，在创造里面所有的情况都是很有程序、很有系统的。
The five elements, one after the other.
就是说，这五个创造元素一个接着一个的展示出来。
Creation coming from subtle to gross.
创造是从轻微的元素再展示出粗糙的元素。
From water, water with taste, the next element to come after water, air.
那么，从接着从水之后会出现什么元素呢？就是这个土的元素。
And what is the particular quality of air?
土的特别的品质是什么？
What does Krishna say in the Krishna said, I am the original fragrance of the air, the aroma.The fragrance, the scent.
那库沙的五德梵哥说了，它是土中的芬芳的源头。
The original fragrance.
那个芳芳香啊，是。
You like perfumes, you know, ladies, they put, you get nashinga oil. Have you tried nashinga oil? You put it on the body, you know, Lord Nashinga, with every at nashinga.Lord Nrsimha is appearance day, we'll bathe the deity of Lord Nrsimha with oil. And that oil is taken as prasadam after Nrsimha's death.
就是说，这个土呢，这是就像香水啊，这些气味。那么如果像在祖女辛嘎这个显现日呢，我们对祖女辛嘎在做一个沐浴，是有那个天然的香油。纯粹的精啊，这个香油，然后对女性的这沐浴啊，然后这些沐浴过后的精油呢，大家可以来收啊，就是当做玛哈，然后我们可以涂在自己身上。
I went to a place in India called Rimuna, where there's a deity of Gopinath, Chirakora Gopinath, the deity who stole the sweet.
在印度去了一个庙，在仁木达那边有一个 Gopinath 的庙，那个神像很出名的，消失光阴的神像是偷了供奉的甜麦饭。
They every day they bathe this a beautiful deity of black, it's in black marble, and they bathe it every day with oil.
那尊神像是很大尊的 Gopinath， 是黑色的一种特别的黑色的石头。他们每天都对这个勾饼呢做沐浴。
And so the deity has a beautiful luster from the oil burn.
那这神像每天被这么油这样洗啊，它非常的光亮，很有光泽。
So that fragrance of the air, that the particular quality of air, but it had that free that.Aroma, that smell.
所以在土的这个元素，它还有另外一个特质，就是说这个它有一种特别的香气那个芬芳香气。
And also it has taste.
然后土这个元素还有味道。
It also has form.
而且是有形体的。
It also has touch.
而且也是我们可以触到。
And it has sound.
而且有声音。
So there's a progression of the elements. With each element, there's another special quality.
所以就是说，所有的元素的发展是有很程序的 发展出来。
Just like there are different rasas with Krishna.
就比方说 Krishna 也是有很多的这个 rasa。
There is Shanta rasa, which is neutrality.
其中一种 rasa 叫 Shanta rasa， 是中性的这种欢欣的滋味。
Then there's Dasa rasa, the servant.
在 Dasa rasa 就是仆人方面的。
Sankhya rasa, the friendship.
而 Sankhya rasa 是友谊之情。
Vatsalya rasa, parenthood.
Vatsalya rasa 就是说。跟 Krishna 的父母之情
，and Madhurya rasa conjugal，
然后还有跟 Krishna 的 Madhurya rasa， 就是说伴侣的关系。
So there's a progression. You can see the relationship becomes more and more.
所以就有很多的进化进展。
From Shanta rasa doesn't have so much appreciation.One simply is attracted by the beauty of Krishna, but is not doing any service.
所以就有Shanta Rasa 就是中性的关系哈，那是受到 Krishna 的这些美的吸引，但是没有更多的这些交流。
But with Dasya Rasa, one's engaging in service, and at the same time, it's also, of course, very attractive.
然后再来是 Dasha Rasa， 就是仆人的关系。那这种仆人之中呢，跟 Krishna 这种服务的仆人的态度也会有很多的滋味。
And when you come to Sankhya Rasa, you're a friend with Krishna. You're also serving Krishna. You also appreciate its beauty.
再来就是 Sankhya Rasa， 就是说。你跟 Krishna 是朋友，然后你也可以是以朋友这样来服务 Krishna， 也有这个关系里面也有很多的这种滋味品味。
And Vatsalya Rasa, when you become a parent, you also naturally appreciate the child, and you will serve the child, and you be friends with the child, but at the same time you're a parent.
那么跟 Krishna 就是父女。父母之情，就是说你把 Krishna 当作小孩，然后来服务这个孩子，要服务 Krishna， 之中也是有很多的这种rasa。
And when if you get to the stage of Madhurya rasa, enjoying conjugal loving with Krishna, then there's all the other rasas that also there within that rasa。
那如果说在有发展到跟 Krishna 是伴侣的关系呢，里面的 rasa 都包含前面各种。
The gopis are always very concerned for Krishna, just like a parent is always concerned for their child.
牧牛姑娘们呢，非常的关心的 Krishna， 就好像父母关心的孩子那样子。
And the gopis are also very dear friends of Krishna.
牧牛姑娘们呢，也是 Krishna 非常亲爱的朋友。
And they always want to serve Krishna.
牧牛姑娘，她们也是一直都是想要来服务 Krishna。
So all the rasas are there within the Madhurya rasa。
所以所有的 rasa 都在这个伴侣之间这个情谊里面都包含了。
And Lord Chaitanya is coming to teach all of us, to tell all of us that we should also develop that love for Krishna like the gopis。
那主 Chaitanya 就教导我们，我们都要来发展这种。就像牧牛姑娘这样的这种关系。
We should chant Hare Krishna. We should awaken our attachment for Krishna.
我们应该念诵 Hare Krishna， 然后来唤起我们对 Krishna 的这种关系。
We all have attachment. We have attachment to the material world, but then we know this world is very temporary, miserable place.
我们都在这个物质世界有依附，可是这个物质世界是短暂的，而且是非常悲哀或悲惨的。
But we want to enjoy, we want a happy life, and that's not wrong. But we have to know where to find a happy life.
如果说我们想要享受了有快乐的生活，这本身是没有错，但是我们要去想从什么地方找到这种真正的快乐。
The nature of the soul is to find happiness with Krishna.
灵魂的本质就是说寻找跟 Krishna 在一起的这种快乐。
But because of our identification with the body, we try to find happiness through the body.
但是由于我们对身体的认同呢，所以我们就想到说去从身体里面去找寻身体方面的快乐。
So there is some happiness there in the body, but it's very temporary.
当然，在身体方面的活动里面会有一些快乐，但是都是非常短暂的。
And it all ends in distress.
结果都是以痛苦结束。
So we are encouraged to find the eternal happiness.
所以我们鼓励大家来寻找这个永恒的快乐。
Then it can be easily arranged by simply chanting Hare Krishna and practicing the principles of Bhakti Yoga.
这可以很容易的来安排，就是从这个念诵 Hare Krishna 进行奉爱瑜伽奉献服务。
Lord Krishna is so kind to us, he's given us this opportunity to come to the association of devotees.
可想对我们非常的仁慈啊，让我们有机会来跟奉献者联谊。
In the association of devotees, we have to cross over this ocean of material existence.
所以在奉献者的联谊之中呢，我们可以跨越这个物质存在的海洋。
And come over the ocean of material existence, we will come into the first. We come into the impersonal Brahman.
那我们要跨越物质的存在这个海洋呢，首先会到这个主非人格的梵的这个阶段。
Just like when Lord Krishna was taking Arjuna to bring back the children of the Brahmana.
就好像主 Krishna 呢要把这个婆罗门的孩子呢让他们起死回生。
Do you know that story?
你们知道那个故事吗？
There was a one Brahmana in Dwarka, and his wife was giving birth to a baby, but when the baby was born, it was miscarriage.
在这 Dwarka 呢有一个婆罗门，他的老婆呢就生了孩子，可是这个小孩子流产了。
So it happened several times. The Brahmana's wife was delivering a baby every time there was a miscarriage.
在这个婆罗门的老婆这个小孩流产的事情发生很多次。
So the Brahmana went to the king of Dwarka. He went to the palace at Dwarka and he complained. He said, you're supposed to be the ruler of Dwarka. Why are you allowing my wife to have a miscarriage?
这个婆罗门呢，他就去到 Dwarka 的国王那边说，你呀，你应该是照料我们全国内的人民的福祉，为什么你允许我的老婆一次又一次的流产这样的事情发生呢？
So it happened at that time, Ugrasena was the king, but Arjuna was there.
那时候的国王乌格塞纳，那么当时阿朱那也在那里。
So Arjuna was upset when he heard this Brahmana come and complain. The Brahmana said, you're the Kshatriya, you're supposed to give protection to the citizens. My wife is giving birth and my child are dying, my children are dying, you're not protecting anybody.
那个婆罗门又对这个阿朱那说呢，你是一个刹帝利，你的职责是应该保护人民的，可是你怎么没做好这件职责呢？你让我的老婆呢又一再的流产。
So Arjuna became upset. He said, listen, I'm a Kshatriya. He said, we're doing our duty. He said, next time your wife delivers a baby, I will make sure that your baby is delivered. I will not allow anything to happen.
那阿朱那也是愤愤不平，听到这样子说，他说，对，我是这个 Kshatriya， 我的职责是保护人们。那如果下一回你妻子怀孕要分娩的时候，我确保你的老婆不会再流产。
And Arjuna vowed, I will give up my life if I cannot protect your child.
那么阿朱那就很气愤地说，如果 没有办法保护你老婆的生产的话呢，我就会自己把自己丢掉自己的生命。
So it happened again. You know, in course of time, the brahmana's wife conceived, and she's ready to deliver the child. And the brahmana come to tell, you know, my wife's getting ready to deliver a child. Are you ready to protect my wife?
所以过了一段时间之后，这个婆罗门的老婆又怀孕，一直到一个时候就准备要生产了。所以这个婆罗门就到这个阿朱那面前说：“我老婆将要来生产分娩了。”你是不是准备好来保护
他呢？ Arjuna said, I'm ready. I'm here. I'm going to protect your child. Don't worry.
Arjuna said, 我准备好，我要准备保护你的小孩，所以你不要担心。
But just when the woman gave birth, immediately there was a miscarriage.
可是呢，这个女子呢，当她把小孩生出来，马上就这个小孩就这样子。马上就流产。
嗯，那 Arjuna was in a difficult situation. What to do?
这时候 Arjuna 就是处在这个很困难的情况呢。那这要怎么办呢？
Because he said, "I'm ready to give up my life if I cannot protect your children."
因为他曾经说过，如果没有办法保护你的孩子的话呢，我就准备放弃我自己的生命。
But Lord Krishna had come there, and Lord Krishna understood the situation.
那么 Krishna 就到了那个现场了。Krishna 知道这个情况。
So Lord Krishna told Arjuna, "You come with me. Get on my chariot. We will go."
那么Krishna 对 Arjuna 说，来，你坐上我车子，我们过去那边。
We have to go and find these children.
我们去找那个孩子。
So Arjuna got on Lord Krishna's chariot, and Krishna drove the chariot right through the coverings of the universe into the Kashi Ocean.
那么Arjuna 就坐上 Krishna 的这个车子，然后Krishna 就一路带着他，一直到了这个宇宙的原因海洋，就是宇宙创造的原因海洋那边。
So the Kaushal Ocean is spiritual, and in the Kaushal Ocean, Mahavishnu is residing there.
这个元婴海洋呢是灵性的境界，那大尾狮牛住在那儿。
And Lord Krishna took Arjuna there. They went to see Mahavishnu.
所以呢，主 Krishna 就带着 Arjuna 去到那儿，然后 Arjuna 就见到这个大尾狮牛。
And Mahavishnu said, "Yes, I'm very glad to see both of you. You've come here to see me. I know why you've come. I arranged all this just so that the two of you would come here and I could have your darshan."
那大尾狮牛非常高兴的，然后对他们说啊，我非常高兴看到你们两位都可以来到这里。其实是我特意这样安排，让你们有机会过来这里。
Then the children of the Brahman are there here. You can take them back.
那么那个婆罗门的孩子就在这儿，你们可以把他带回去。
Mahavishnu had stolen these children just to bring Lord Krishna so he could see Krishna and Arjuna.
So it's 大尾狮牛把那个婆罗门的孩子偷过来，这样制造那个机会让 Krishna 可以过来这里，可以看到。
Krishna had to go into the Brahmajyoti, into that causal ocean, to get these children to bring them back to the man.
所以 Krishna 必须呢穿过这个梵光。然后再去到这个元婴海洋那边，然后把这些孩子们带着起死回生带回来。
So Lord Krishna could go there and could go into the Brahmajyoti, could do these things.
所以 Krishna 也可以去到那边呢，去到这梵光那边呢去做这个事情的。
But devotees were not very much interested in the Brahma.
但是我们身为主的奉献者，对于这个梵光这些没有很大的兴趣。
We are more attracted to the beauty of Krishna, the form of Krishna.
我们是更加的被 Krishna 的形体特别是说我们看到的神像。
Just like when Arjuna saw the Vishwarup, he saw that universal form of Lord Krishna, was not attracted. Just show me your original form.
就好像。阿朱那有一段时候看到 Krishna 的宇宙形体，那阿朱那觉得他不是，就 就是他觉得这个有什么吸引力，他希望就想啊回复到原来的形体。
We like, although we become afraid of being persons, by nature we are all persons, we are all personalities, we all have an eternal personality.
啊，我们都，我们是害怕的，害怕是作为人，可是呢，在本质上我们都有人格性，那我们都是一个个体的这种人。
But we're not this body.We identify with this body. This is only the temporary.
但我们也不是这个身体，因为这个物质的身体只是一个短暂的一个身份。
We all have an eternal spiritual relationship with Lord Krishna.
我们每一位都跟 Krishna 有一个永恒存在的这样关系。
We want to awaken that spiritual consciousness.
我们想要来唤醒。
And it's possible by just chanting Hare Krishna and keeping ourselves engaged in Krishna's service.
这是可能就是来进行念诵这个 Hare Krishna Krishna 的圣名，这样来进行是可以唤醒的。
We have a spiritual body. We have a spiritual form.
我们呢，每一位都有一个灵性的身体，灵性的形体。
And that is without any of the miseries or problems of the material body.
那这个原来的灵性的身体没有任何物质身体的各种悲哀。
So Lord Krishna came to speak Bhagavad Gita to invite all of us to go back to him.
所以 Krishna 就这样子讲述了国家梵歌，来邀请我们所有的人都回到那里去。
Tell us this place. This is not.Our real home.
这个世界不是我们真正的家。
But the home, our home is there, it's waiting for us.
但是我们家是存在的，而且等着我们回去。
We say home is where the heart is.
我们有个俗话，就是家在哪里，心就在那。
So we want to go there to them.
所以我们就想要回到那里去。
Okay, any question?
任何问题。
Yeah. 刚才讲到水，实际上水也有知觉，比如说一个纯净的水，它放在那边，我这个能量往这个体内的时候，它是没有能量，都懂的。假如你跟他讲一些好话，或者是里面不断按照给他听的话，他经过一吸氧，是有那个能量就转得很快。
那有一本书特别讲到，
对，讲到这里，你植物也是一样。一个盆栽，你天天跟他讲好话，他就开得很茂盛。你天天骂他，他妈骂他，你笨蛋，为什么说像这类的话，他是掉回来。这个是。
He raised something about that the water also has consciousness. He heard that the vibration of atmosphere is not good. The water's quality is not good, but the atmosphere is good. The water also has the consciousness.The plant also, if you treat the plant well, it grows nicely. If you treat the plant very bad, then the plant also show their conscious reaction.
Well, water is not a living entity on its own.
水本身不是生物，水本身，不论在化学
对它的
生物。There may be living entities in the water.
说到你说的那状况，可能在水里面有一些生物。
But water on its own doesn't have consciousness.
Hydrogen and oxygen only. 水没有生命，它只是二氧化碳那个氢气跟水跟氧气结合的，是那种元素结构而已。
那同时呢，灵魂最近有一个，在十九世纪的时候，有科学家慢慢的研究出来量子力学，后来才发现哦，原来真的有灵魂的存在。十九世纪初期，所以现在在物理学，人类有两个最大的，就是爱因斯坦相对论，还有现在最近的 量子力学，这是这两个重大的发现。严格经过测试，
没关系，这个好不了他。
对，
我不是知道，我知道你说的。
对，我是讲这个以这个来看看啊，看那些后面其他的题目来讨论，并不是说那个。
Beginning of 19th century, there is a very important discovery about the quantum theory. So it shows the source of any vibration related to the quantum reaction. And so in the modern days, now the two important aspects, one is Einstein's theory and another one the quantum theory.
Yes, but they still don't have the perfect knowledge.
即便是爱因斯坦的相对论，还有这个量子力学，他们的知识还不完整。
对，刚刚才提的，才慢慢的提的。
他们做什么偏边？做什么偏边？
爱因斯坦 was reading the Bhagavad Gita.
爱因斯坦以前他也是活的时候读国家梵歌。
He was appreciating.
他非常欣赏国家梵歌。
This knowledge is more than.Whatever he could reveal.
他读国家梵歌的时候非常的赞叹，就说国家梵歌里面的知识。
Who made the brain? Who gave Einstein that brain? Who made that brain?
那爱因斯坦的这个他的脑力，他的脑子是谁给他？谁给他那种智力？
他最后爱因斯坦他发明这么多东西，他最后确定这个世界有神的存在。有很多他没办法解释。
Einstein have many discoveries, and finally he concluded that there is God existed, because so many things we notice but we cannot have enough information or knowledge to explain that.
Yeah.
文道那个他们第四页英文是二十五个，英文是一个天平。
There's some people who just go to.Like the body, the soul in the body, they go to weight, say the soul is 25 grams.
So many conditioned souls.
这个灵魂在这物质世界受很多条件的制约。
They cannot understand the spiritual science.
一般人无法了解灵性的科学。
The soul does not have any weight.
灵魂没有我们物质的这种重量。
Doesn't have any physical quality.
灵魂没有我们物质的品质。
Material scientists, chemists, or physics, they cannot understand the spiritual science.
物质的科学家们，不管他们是物理学家、化学家，都无法了解这灵性的科学。
They only know material science.
他们知道只是物质方面的科学。
虽然他是没有那个指标，但是有能量比例。
The soul has no weight, but there is energy.
Yeah, of course, that's a spiritual energy.
肯定的，灵魂有能量，它是灵性的能量。
Okay, yeah.
重量可能在死后的心脏，那称的重量会不一样。
对，
像那个水汽都没有水汽重量不一样。
对，
他
们
是
这
样
测，
他们
说
一直问题是想办法去找到这个答案，
让
你这样。
所以他们现在还不承认这个是真的。所以他们不要那个。I said, The soul of the body, different conditions, sometimes it's humid, maybe way more, or not humid, maybe less.
Where is Einstein now?
Einstein, 现在在哪里？
Einstein, 不不见。
回去归哪里
？Go to see his father, 去找他爸爸。Einstein, 回去找爸爸。
那请问？如果灵魂都是见不到，然后我们自己不知道我们是这个，我们
肉眼看不到，
一举一动都不是灵魂。
啊，你说我们身体？
我们身体在动啊，在想啊，所以这就不是灵魂。那我们什么时候知道我们是灵魂的主人？
就是 说我们是灵魂，而且是
其他都是假象吗？都是假我吗？一直在说话，一直在动作啊，这些通通是假我吗？
这个爱是不能是spiritual form， 所以 whatever our action or movement， how it works， and when we can know we are the master of the body， the soul is the master of the body， when we can see our real form。
Well, when we surrender to Krishna.
啊，可以见到真正原来灵性形体的时候，就是跟 Krishna 臣服的时候。
You have to surrender to Krishna.
你必须要跟 Krishna 来臣服。
Then you can see the spiritual form.
那时候就可以去看到灵性的形体。
就是我们。日常生活所想所思都是 Krishna 意识，那就是灵魂在展现嘛。
Whatever in our daily activity, our thinking, our moving, it's a thinking related to Krishna. That is the soul's action. Is that?
Well, it depends how you relate to Krishna.
就看你怎么样去跟 Krishna。
And you're relating in a favorable way.
你跟 Krishna 的关系是一种，所以合宜的方式吗？嗯。
Right. We use our senses. We should use the senses in the service of Krishna.
我们必须用我们的感官来服务 Krishna。
Awesome. It's not just everything you do is for Krishna, but you have to do it in the you have to do activities which are pleasing to Krishna.
不是说我们所做的一切都是关于 Krishna 这一句，我们必须是真的就是为了 Krishna 而做事。
他要说什么？关于供奉神像的问题，就是我女儿做了，她用纸黏土捏了 Krishna 和那个 Radharani， 还有母牛、小牛，然后她把它跟那个 Jagannath、Subhadra、Balarama 还有Nityananda 他们全都摆在一起供奉，但是他现在他听说供奉 Krishna 和 Radharani 要有很高的条件才可以，不能随便供奉，所以他现在担忧说是不是应该把那个神像收起来，不要再供奉。
你说谁做的？
他女儿和小孩。
She did that amador 神像。How did she get so many deities? Who gave her all the deities?
The daughter made the artificial clay make the form of the Radha Krishna. Some people say if you worship Radha Krishna, you need a very high qualification. So it is okay that if you worship Radha Krishna in the kind of clay or handmade clay form.
Yeah, well, yeah, there is a high standard for worshipping Radha and Krishna.
去崇拜 Radha Krishna 确实有比较高的标准。
Usually we encourage people to worship Gornitai. They're very merciful.
我们一般鼓励人们去崇拜 Gornitai， 因为 Gornitai 非常的仁慈。
You can worship them just by chanting.But Radha and Krishna, if your daughter has made some forms of Radha and Krishna, and she's worshipping them, how is she worshipping? What is she doing?
如果你的女儿做这个 Radha Krishna， 她怎么样进行对他们的崇拜？
他是先研究经典，就是他们两个有什么特色，身上有什么物品，他做了以后就每天供奉水，然后有时候供奉水果食物。
The sheep chicken, 他给他们换衣服吗？
嗯，冬天的时候给他们加温暖的衣服。
这么简单。The real importance about Rama Krishna and the ornaments they change for them and offer water and sometimes fruit and winter maybe give them a warm clothing.
但是都非常的简陋。
Very simple items.
那有时候我们会一起在神像面前贴坦。
哦、oh, ，sometimes we do keep it in front of them.
Well, I mean, not wrong, but you know, the worship is not going to be exactly as people would worship it, an established form of Radha and Krishna.To worship the deity of Radha and Krishna, there's many rules and regulations and qualifications.
当然，你们这样做也没有错。可是不像说正式崇拜 Radha Krishna， 确实有很多的规范、很多的规矩，啊，也有很多的一些细节跟资格。
But there's no doubt that your daughter must have some devotion for Radha and Krishna, and that's an important quality.Which Krishna wants, he wants a devotion.
没有毫无疑问，你的女儿应该对 Radha Krishna 还是有点奉爱哈。那重点也是 Radha Krishna， 他也需要是我们对他们的奉爱。
So she can continue to worship as she does.
所以她可以继续你们的崇拜。
Thank you.
And we hope she will continue.
嗯，希望她会继续。
Throughout her life.
嗯。May I ask more question?
Yeah.
就是听说要。每天念十六串的念珠，整整念一年以后才可以开始找灵性导师皈依。但是，因为我的语速很慢，念得很慢，那我觉得我好像永远达不到这个目标，怎么办？
目达不到什么样的目标？
我没有办法，没有办法一天那个念十六圈，因为我念得很慢，花很多时间，就是要工作，然后有家庭生活。那这样子的话，我是不是就没办法，一直没办法去找灵性导师？
哦。Well, you can take instruction, even if you can't take initiation. You can take instruction from the teachers.
好，就是即使现在没办法到达这个所谓要求标准，但是你可以去请求接受一点训示，然后根据那些训示去进行。就是还没有请求你有一个对象可以跟他请教跟他询问什么的。
那这位训示的老师他是必须要有咕噜的资格吗？还是说只要是资深的？
Yeah, the qualification is the same. Diksha and Shiksha. And Shunsha, GD, they were the younger they were. Same.No difference.
训示的老师跟这个祈福的老师一样，在有一个道理上是一样的意思，但是就是本身是一个这个训示或祈福的侮辱，他一定要有一些资格。
So you take shelter.You can take shelter of a spiritual teacher, you can take instruction from him.
所以可以去托庇一个灵性的老师，然后从那边接受训示。
But the initiation, you should chant 16 rounds for Krishna.
但是如果要得到启迪，就是每天的十六圈。
So you find it difficult to chant 16 rounds, so just be satisfied to take instruction.
那如果说因为各种工作家务忙碌没办法念完十六卷，那就是先接受训示。